Nearly 128,000 properties lie empty in London, according to government figures. That's double the number needed to house the estimated 60,000 homeless families in the capital. Campaigners say it's a scandal.
We're not saying that if you bring all empty properties back into use, all homeless people would be housed. I mean, that plainly isn't the case. There's no simple equation between the two lots of numbers. However, there are many properties that are in a reasonable state, even though they're empty, which could be brought back into short-term use for homeless people.
Both private and public sector landlords are being blamed. Environment Minister Lord Caithness today attacked local authorities for what he called the deplorable spectacle of homeless people being lodged in bed and breakfast hotels while council houses lay empty. He told a housing conference in London that one authority took an average of 24 weeks to re-let a property. Private landlords do even worse. Portman Estates own this block of 12 four-storey buildings in George Street, central London. It's been empty for 2 years. Campaigners want a change in the law so landlords are forced to let their properties. The empty property bill would give local councils the power to take over most buildings left empty for at least 2 years. They'd be able to rent them out for 5 years, managed by an organisation like a housing association, before they were handed back. The bill gets its second reading in the Commons tomorrow, but already seems almost certain to fail.
The government have a dogma about these things. They say that they can't interfere with private ownership, and they spend their time criticising councils. Councils deserve to be criticised, but private owners own far more empty property than any council in the country does, and the government don't like the idea that it might interfere with the right of ownership.
The landlords themselves have hit back. The Association of Local Authorities say only 3% of local government properties were empty last year, a 15% reduction. But those fighting for the homeless say no landlord can justify leaving even one potential home empty.